अजानुलंबित भुजौ कनकावदतु संकेतनैकपितरु कमलायताक्ष विशाम्बरौ द्विजवरौ जुगधर्मपालौ वंदे जगत्प्रियकरौ करुणावतारौ हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे। नमामि गंगे तव पाद पंकजं सुरासुरैर्वन्दितो दिव्यरूपं भुक्तिं च मुक्तिं च ददासि नित्यं भावानुरूपेण सदा नरानं गंगातरंगरमणीयजटाकलापं गौरीनिरन्तरविभूषितवामभागं नारायणो प्रियमनंगमदापहारं वाराणसीपुरपति भजवीशनाथं वागीशजुष्वदने लक्ष्मीर्जस्य च वक्षसि यस्यास्ति हृदय संवित्त्वं नृसिंहमहं भजे। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे। देवर्षि भूतात्मनिनां पितॄणां न किंकरो नायं ऋणी च राजन् सर्वात्मनाय शरणं शरण्यं गतो मुकुंदं परिहित्वकर्तं। देवर्षि भूतात्मनिनां पितॄणां न किंकरो नायं ऋणी च रायण सर्वात्मनाय शरणं शरण्यं गतो मुकुंदं परिहित्वकर्तं। गौरियो गोष्ठीपति श्री शिल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी जगत प्रभुपाद जगत गुरु टोल्ड दैट द क्लीन हार्ट वेरी प्योर हार्ट ऑफ एनी डिवोटी इज द एक्चुअली सिटिंग प्लेस फॉर सुप्रीम लॉर्ड। द प्योर हार्ट ऑफ एन प्योर डिवोटी is the exact place where Supreme Lord can take rest. If heart is not cleaned, parimarjan, if heart is not clean, that means there surely purushobhiman, I mean doership, I am man, you are woman, I am idiot, this kind of conception, different kind of false conception can come. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu never teach us this way. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu never teach us that I can discuss this point first, then I can go to the topics I am running. Actually, Prabhupada speaking, that the pure heart of a pure devotee is the exact place where Supreme Lord can take rest. If heart is not clean through Sankirtan, Harikatha, anyway, then there is doership, purushabhiman. I am the doer, say, I am man, you are whom, you are woman, you are dirty, I am very pure, I am idiot. This kind of concession can come. With full respect, Shraddha, if you go on hearing Harikatha, then surely you can purify your heart. But you are not doing so, that's why your heart is not purified. Shraddha Purvak, Baba speaking, with full respect, Shraddha, with full respect, if you go on hearing Harikatha, if you want to stay inside, among Guru Vaishnava, In that case, we can purify our heart. That's why Brahma also, after making mistake, one kind of lila actually, after making mistake, he wanted to measure the power of, is Supreme Lord or not? Maybe is the son of Nanda Maharaj, not Supreme Lord. He wanted to estimate, measure. Miyate anaya iti maya. Our estimation mood, well, always we are busy with estimation mood. This is called actually baddha avastha, bonded condition. Always we are estimation. The Brahma actually was manifesting this kind of leela. But after that, Brahma was crying in front of Supreme Lord, praying from heart that Gyane prayasa mudapasa namanti eva jivanti sanmukuritam bhavadiyo vartam sthanes thanes thitasutigatam tonubang manovir je prayaso ajitopi jitopi tois trilokyam. This sloka, Brahma was crying and speaking. So actually, this kind of estimation, the mood of estimation, you know, logical interpretation, this Brahma like to throw away. Mayavad, a conception of gyan, dry knowledge. Gyane prayasa mudapasa, I am Brahma. I am Brahma, I am elevated, I am so high. Brahma speaking, gyane prayasa mudapasa. That gyano prayasa mudapasa means dry knowledge. Not that I can discuss some point from Rasamrita Sindhu, you can understand. The knowledge of devotion is not at all prohibited. If I am going to hear Harikatha from the lotus mouth of Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj, if I am not going to increase my bhakti, then what kind of, practice I am doing of, you know, Harikatha, Harikirtan, listening, how I am doing? All mistake. So, Gyane Prayasa Mudabhasa Namanti Eva. Only the way I already told, and the sloka I started with also going to unveil this mystery, that submission, 100% submission, actually people are so biased, so, you know, popped up, they have so false ego. Still today, they don't understand what I mean to say. They don't understand what I mean to say. If they are going to understand why they are making mistake, why they are making mistake all the time? They are doing aparad and going back in bhajan. Why? So Brahma speaking, Gyane prayasa mudabhasa namanti eva. Namanti eva mean namo, namo, namanti eva mean namo mean no, no mean no. You know, prohibited. What is prohibited? To show false ego. No, mo. Mane no mean no and mo mean ahankar I already throw onto your lotus feet. That is called pranam. Dandavat pranam. Mean, Maharaj, I am going to throw my false ego, I am going to submit fully, and my ahankar, my false ego, I am going to throw away. This is called pranam. Nobody knows the meaning of pranam. So, gyane prayaso mudabhasa namanti eva jivanti, how you Brahma speaking, how he like to live, jivanti san mukharitam bevadiyo bhartam, sat mukham iritam, from the lotus mouth of pure Guru Vaishnava, they are speaking Harikatha, I like to hear, staying among pure sadhus all the time, sthane sthita, I mean, in the association of Guru Vaishnava, pure Guru Vaishnava, I like to hear Harikatha, sthane sthita sutigatam tonubhang manovi, Tanu bang manubi mean by body speech of mind, by body speech and mind submission. With full submission, I am going to stay in front of pure sadhus. I am going to show my submission. And then I can go on hearing Harikatha. And then in that case, Harikatha can never go in vain. Harikatha is so powerful if there is no aparad. If there is tremendous aparad inside your heart, and then in that case you cannot understand the actual meaning of Harikatha. what is the essence of Harikatha? You cannot understand. You are hearing. You want to prove that I am hearing, but you are not hearing. So, actual Harikatha, if you hear, Harikatha is so powerful, Baba speaking, and that Harikatha surely going to show his reaction inside your heart. Reaction means cleaning procedure can take place. But if there is no cleaning procedure going on, that means there is aparad. Harikatha, after hearing from big, big elevated sadhus, still if I am not getting any result, that surely means tate yani aparad ache prachur. Chaitanya Charitamrita is written, in that case, if I am not getting any result, after hearing Harikatha, powerful Harikatha, that surely means tate yani aparad ache prachur. That means surely big aparad, big great aparads are there. Aparad is there. That's why nam aparad, dham aparad, you know, Vaishnava aparad, so many aparad, many aparad, countless aparad can be there. I can try to touch this point because otherwise people, people try to, you know, people try to, you know, put me in false position. They think that I am maintaining my purity, but idiot number one, you are thinking that I am maintaining that kind of purity, which can allow you giving inspiration to hate others. What do you think? What do you think? My purity maintain, you can try to follow me? You can follow me? Prabhupada speaking, I am acting as acharya, so I have to maintain this rank. That means you can also try to imitate me? To get destroyed in devotional life? What do you think? Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj speaking, those who are going to imitate false imitation, they are going to get burnt up. Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj. You know, if you follow Guru Vaishnava, you will have to follow their instruction. Instruction you will have to follow. You will have to make balance. If you cannot keep balance, then you can get lost. Be careful. I can give some example. People think so wrong way, you see. They are so foolish. I told you, na, that in front of Brihaspati, Devguru, Birochan and Indra going to take lesson. But after the, you know, after the lesson is over, Birochan going to express his some negative mood, whereas Indra going to express some positive mood, not completely. After that again, Indra was bound to hear from Devguru Brihaspati. This is the condition. Your sanskar, you are driven by your sanskar. You are not going to follow me. 100% sure I am. You are driven by your old sanskar. You cannot do Harinam because you are doing aparad. If you cannot cut aparad, everything, if you cannot understand, you will have to see the whole world in relation to Supreme Lord. That I told Rantidev, you cannot remember. You cannot remember anything. Rantidev was successful because Rantidev could see the whole world in relation to Supreme Lord. But you cannot see. You can see in a woman, man, you know, old, you know, this you can see. Nothing you can see. This is your position. Eh? You cannot purify yourself. How you can do? Because you are doing aparad. You know? People think I hate Matajis. Who told you? Who told you that I hate Matajis? Who told you this kind of bad conception? How you develop? How you develop this kind of conception? If I cannot see Radharani inside all Matajis, then how I can do bhajan? How I can speak Harikatha? Is possible for me? Foolish number one. I hate Matajis. Who told you? Huh? am very sorry, people cannot understand what I mean to say. What is my etiquette? What is my acharan? They cannot. They like to imitate me. Imitation. They like to do and they like to die. Prabhupada speaking, we cannot get the association of insincere peoples. We want to get the association of pure devotees, and pure, at least medium, madhyam adhikaris, those who are having no material conception, nothing, and the lotus feet of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, lotus feet of Krishna Chaitanya, Sri Krishna Mahaprabhu, Sri Krishna Bhagavan is our eternal place. We'll have to reach that place, eternal place. Prabhupada speaking, the lotus feet of Krishna is our eternal place. Krishna Pad Padmo is the eternal health of the soul. Krishna Pad Padmo in the lotus feet of Krishna Charan or Krishna Chaitanya Charan is the eternal health of the soul is situated. Try to understand this point. If my heart is not cleaned, then I can see diversity. I can see different. If I am not established in Advaita and Tattva, then I can see different kind of thing, diversity, and which can put me in trouble. Through Sankirtan, we'll have to clean our heart. Mahaprabhu teaching us. Mahaprabhu was showing so much restriction because Mahaprabhu was showing the acharan of a perfect acharya. If you want to take the exact teachings to the point, exact teachings of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, then surely you will have to come unto the lotus feet of Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Nowhere in this 14 world you can get the exact teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. You will have to depend upon Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada. They are showing so nice acharan and everything. Sometime Prabhupada was very excited, showing some, you know, leela. Prabhupada shouting and speaking. Why you are going to take control over devotees, you know? It is my duty. I am acting as an acharya, it is my duty. You are going to show. It is my duty. Why you take trouble? Eh? You think you are a big teacher? Eh? You are idealism, your character, everything, you think so? You like to ignore others? Eh? So this way, Prabhupada was bound to show that kind of idealism, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, this way, because they are going to show some example in front of people. That's why. That Mahaprabhu was so strict, but still that Mahaprabhu, I see, we can see, that Mahaprabhu, you know, when doing Nilachal Leela, he is Acharya. Even in Grihastha form, Mahaprabhu was here, was showing so nice, you know, Grihastha Leela. That is also idealism, big idealism. In Purushottam Dham, when Mahaprabhu was showing Sannyas Leela, there also, Mahaprabhu was so strict, that he was bound to give punishment to Chatori Das, these, that, so many cases are there. But that Mahaprabhu, when in Jagannath temple, one day watching Jagannath with full absorbing mood, in that case, one old lady, you know, from tribal lady, is very with absorbing mood watching Jagannath. She cannot see properly. She was bound to take the help of Jagannath, you know, Guru Stamba pillar, and one leg going to put on the soldier of Mahaprabhu. Then Swarup Gosai, all devotees from backside, they are shouting, "Oi, what you are doing?" Mahaprabhu, Antaryami, knowing everything, Mahaprabhu speaking, "Don't disturb her. Don't disturb her. Let her see Jagannath. I cannot develop that kind of, you know, that kind of mood, that kind of, you know, strong attraction for Jagannath. With absorbing mood, she is watching Jagannath. Even she cannot understand, she is going to put one leg on my shoulder. You see this point. So Mahaprabhu going to hate woman, huh? I am going to hate woman. Who told you? Who told you? This way, Mahaprabhu saying this way. Another example, so many examples I can give. Another example I can give to you, so that at least you cannot, you know, lose your humanity. If your humanity is lost, how you can do bhajan? Srila Bhaman Goswami Maharaj used to say, I also often like to say this point, if I cannot become a perfect man, then when I can become a sadhu? When I can become a sadhu, if I cannot become a complete man, if I am not, you know, going to express humanity, degradation of humanity is very painful. You have no love for each other, everything, you know. So merciless, you know, passioned, heartless. Yeah. You have no mutual respect, no mutual love, so that they can build up. You are breaking. Your mood is breaking mood. And you know, Popa speaking, na? No making, only breaking. No making, only breaking mood. You have only breaking mood. You like to break. I like to create one centrifugal force. I like to make one centrifugal force so that depending upon Bhaktivinoda Thakur Prabhupada, all like a smooth, you know, a wheel rolling, you know, around, moving around. But you are going to break. Prabhupada writing one article, there is writing, only breaking, no making. You are only breaking, no making. Because you have no humanity. If you have humanity, then why you are going to show this kind of inhuman activities? In front of you, somebody going to die, you are going to show your purity? Idiot number one. Foolish. I like to throw you out. I cannot accept you. Foolish. Purity. What kind of purity you have? Huh? What kind of purity you mean? Srila Bhaman Goswami Maharaj used to speak this way. Bhaman Goswami Maharaj. If you cannot become a man, then how you can become a devotee? How you can become a pure sadhu? Then how you can become an acharya? At present, due to the influence of maya, everything is possible. He is not even man, he become acharya. He is not even man, he become acharya. This is only possible in this Kalikal due to the influence of maya. Only due to the influence of maya. Nothing else. You are inside maya. So everything you are watching maya. Everywhere you see, those who are pratishthakami, those who are always in favor of collecting pratishtha, every moment they are thinking, how I can collect pratishtha from here? How I can collect pratishtha? Those who are having weakness for women, they are watching everywhere women, dirty woman. He is only pure, everywhere watching. Hari Maharaj, Srila Bhaman Goswami Maharaj, one day, Srila Bhaman Goswami Maharaj was one day in Assam preaching tour. He was so sick, fever, high fever. You know, at present, no acharya can think about this kind of preaching. Without room, without any facility, Madhava Goswami Maharaj doing preaching. You can do. You want to prove that you're a great Vaishnava, huh? You can go. I can throw you there. You can do. Go there and do preaching. Srila Madhava Goswami Maharaj preaching in Assam. No facility. Even knows where to stay. Those pure Assamese people, they have no place to stay. Madhava Goswami Maharaj, you know, sleeping on, you know, bamboo structure outside. You know, they have no room. You know, clay room. Then Bhakti Vallabh Chittu Goswami Maharaj sleeping just in train. You can find first bunk, middle bunk, last bunk, there is bunk. Bamboo structure. Madhava Goswami Maharaj is sleeping up, Tita Goswami Maharaj sleeping down, second, and third somebody. Tita Goswami Maharaj told me, Maharaj, night time I am getting the sound of snake going, shaw, shaw, shaw. But still I have no fear because Gurudev is there. Guru kevai, Guru kipa hi kevalam. Guru kipa hi kevalam. That's why I cannot fear. Tita Goswami Maharaj, showing the example of submission. Why I love Tita Goswami Maharaj? He is showing the example of submission. How to show submission? No kapat bhav, nothing. Very plain hearted he was. No complication. People misunderstood him, wanted to avoid him, wanted to disobey him, neglect him. I know. And they are getting that kind of result according to their activities they are getting. Srila Bhavan Goswami Maharaj speaking, actually, I heard it from his sevak. The one day Guru Maharaj was there, so high fever. And he was, given one place inside one clay room there. And night time fever going up and up. Sevak going to put water on head. And that Mataji, very plain hearted, pure Mataji. She is crying and catching the head of Bhavan Goswami Maharaj and speaking, Gurudev, tor ki holo? Gurudev, tor ki holo? A crude Bengali language. Gurudev, what happened to you? What happened to you, Gurudev? What happened to you? She is crying and touching the head of Gurudev. And Sevak saying, don't touch the head of Gurudev. Bhavan Goswami has been, let her touch my heart. Allow her. This kind of tremendous attraction for Guru Vaishnava is very, very urgent thing. I am heartless. That's why I am going to teach you opposite way. I am teaching now how to hate Mataji. Otherwise, how you are learning? I am heartless now. I am giving you wrong teachings. That's why you are learning wrong thing. Every time you are going to be driven by Maya. Balavan adaro yasso na sad guru padam bhuje sutoirapitasso sastrair kishne bhakti na jayate. You cannot get even a drop of bhakti, not a particle of bhakti, because you are doing mistake, aparad. Krishna bhakti, you can memorize all shastra. What it concerned to me? Until and unless you are going to develop strong, tremendous attraction for Guru Vaishnava. Tremendous attraction, man, you are ready to give life for Guru Vaishnava. Only the thing you are learning, how to imitate. Maharaj maintaining purity. So I can also maintain purity. Are you foolish? I am acting as acharya. I am not giving initiation, but still, that's why you'll have to show. Inside I have tremendous love for those Matajis. I can see Radharani. How I can hate them? Ha ha. Oh my God. What kind of teaching you are getting from me? Prabhupada never teach us that way. Those who are going to show that kind of attitude, 100% I'm sure they have weakness. They have some passive calm inside their heart, which is going to kill them. It's going to surely going to kill them. If they cannot rectify within this, in between, in middle, then they are going to rain themselves. One example I give to a big acharya, he kick on my head, on my chest, simply because I told him that you are selected as acharya. You are sannyasi. You should not go to your home. You should not keep relation with your home. He kicked on my head. You should not read homeopathic books. It is prohibited. Rupa Goswami was speaking. Bahu gantok kala abhyas nishiddho. It is prohibited to learn so many art and craft, books and, unnecessarily, without which those books have no relation with devotional feel, no, nothing. They are going to read that kind of, because they have anyavilas. This way I give two or three instructions. Before they speak, you are non-different from Gurudev. We can see clearly our Gurudev is there. They pay prostrate a flat dandavat in front of me, want to worship my lotus feet, you know. You know, they want to pray. They are crying in front of my lotus feet. They are falling down, want to wash my lotus feet, you know. But I say, then I could realize, they are showing this kind of exhibition, tomorrow they can kick me, surely. I never expect you worship me. If you have any respect, you can show inside your heart. Physically, I cannot allow you. But they wanted to forcefully. And after that, now they kick on my chest. Now they cannot see their Gurudev, because I am speaking about Prabhupada. That's why they are now blind. They cannot see their Gurudev inside my heart. You see, what is the great influence of Maya? You see, what is the great influence? You know, I told them, you see, I never teach you that way. I never wanted to speak, you know, that way. You are going to misunderstand me. You are going to misunderstand me, Deva. And Acharya is going to show his unique Acharyaship. Tremendous love for Guru Vaishnava means you will have to carry out all the orders of Guru Vaishnava. You are going to follow bonded soul. If you are going to follow a bonded soul as Acharya, I have no responsibility. What I can do? You can hear and try to rectify. Yesterday I told, I can give some example from Shastra. Now you see, they told, they speaking, my Gurudev, allow me to go to home. I told you, it cannot so happen. It cannot so happen. Sadguru can never speak that way. Sadguru can never speak that way. You are speaking wrong. My Gurudev told, if you cannot run so much temple, you can take all, collect all deities in one room and go on worshipping, you do bhajan. I told you, Guru Maharaj wanted to cheat you, because Gaudiya devotees can never speak that way. Gurudev could realize that you are useless. You are idiot. That's why Gurudev wanted to cheat you. A Sadguru can never speak that way. You can close all temples and bring all deities here in one room and go on offering tulsis and flowers. Cannot say. Because we are under the guidance of Prabhupada, means we are under the guidance of Radharani. We are under the guidance of Rupa Goswami. I can show you that Acharyaship and Prabhupada, you are hearing, na? The unique Acharyaship of Srila Prabhupada. After that, you know Acharyaship and Prabhupada. After that, I can discuss Srila Prabhupada and Radha Anugatya. I can show you. What do you mean by Radha Anugatya? Eh? Never one Sadguru can never speak that way, Gaudiya Sadguru. No, never. Ours is continuous Hari Sankirtan, Hari Katha. How Gurudev can teach me that you can stop writing and speaking Harikatha, you can go on doing Harinam. Gurudev can never speak. At the age of 98, Gurudev told, Guru Maharaj told me, Prabhupada, give me this pain. And up to my last, you know, day, I am bound to do this seva. Same way I can proclaim, my Guru Maharaj give this. I cannot stop my speech, I cannot stop my Harikatha. I cannot stop. It's not possible. Maybe one people in the world can accept. Maybe two or maybe not. But still, I should go on doing my duty. And it is also one kind of bhajan for me. It is given by Prabhupada, you know, Guru Varga. So I told him, your Gurudev told you did that way. To go to, yes, my Gurudev told him. I said, Gurudev can never give this kind of instruction. That one sannyasi or acharya can go to whom, keep relation. Then other people, what they can, I can teach you, hey, try to develop detachment. Try to develop detachment, idiot. Eh? And I myself not going to follow. I am going to try to develop detachment. I know. Ma kuru dhana jana jovana garbam, harati nimeshat kalo sarvam. I can sing nicely. I can cheat you all. Eh? There is a cheating propensity. One Sadguru can never speak that way. artham anartham bhavayanit anitvam. I can sing, but I cannot follow myself. So what use if I speak Harikatha? Ma kuru dhano jano jovana garvam harati nimeshat kalo sarvam. All teaching for you, not for me. I am that kind of acharya. Only going to pass lecture. Not going to fall. Artham anartham bhavayo nitya. Are money and opulence, all danger, don't try to. I am myself going for money collection. So many money. This is my status, you see. I told that foolish acharya. I told yesterday, if somebody going to die himself is good. If some acharya going to die with all his thousands of followers, it's a great danger. Great danger. We are not increasing our consciousness to stop this situation, corrupted situation. We are not going to, let them go, Maharaj, what to do? I am busy with my Guru Maharaj's temple. Big sevak. Whereas Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, it is a duty, main duty of a perfect acharya to get responsibility, take responsibility of the whole sampradaya. Nobody, sampradaya can go. What is concerned to me? I am busy, I can show exhibition. So big temple of Guru Maharaj, Samadhi Mandir. See, I am a great devotee. I can make more big temple than Prabhupada. Foolish number one. They are not going to take information that Gurudev, for whom you are doing this seva, he is going to satisfy or not. So foolish. They have no calculation. They don't know. You are doing seva. Seva means, if I am doing seva of Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Guru Padma, Guru Bhargava, then I should pay attention to the factor that I am going to satisfy Gurudev or not. If my Gurudev is not at all satisfied, what kind of seva I have done? By making a big temple, more big than Prabhupada. Prabhupada is a small man. Small devotee, my Gurudev is, great devotee. Mayavadi, 100%, I can touch the lotus feet of Prabhupada and speak. That much confidence I have, Mayavadi. All Mayavadi. Their efforts, externally is very nice, sweet. Their efforts, but actually they are Mayavadi. I can 100% touch Gita, Bhagavad and speak. Mayavadi, they have no conception about devotion, nothing. So I told that foolish acharya who is going to kill thousands of people in this society. That's why this kind of conception should be stopped. We should discuss what Prabhupada wanted to speak about acharyasya. 100% all the time. Those who are envious, they can come to fight with us and they can get lost in this infinity world. Never in infinity world. Infinity period, they cannot come out again. And it is the responsibility of Balaram to provide a danda. Pashunam lagaro laguro jatha. I am not interested. I can speak only Harikatha. If they are going to take step, then they can feel the result. They can feel the result. If at all I am speaking by the desire of Nityananda, then if I am going to speak Harikatha for who collect money, position, then it is different thing. If at all I am speaking Harikatha by the desire of Nityananda, then let them come and see the result. So I am not going to, they can get punishment automatically. They are getting 100%. They can get more and more. Somebody going to die, very negative way. Those who are against Gauriya Mata and Gauriya devotees, Prabhupada, each and every speech can prove that they are Mayavadi. Like Prabhupada told, not that day I was speaking, maybe 1 month or 2 months ago. Prabhupada hearing from his bhajan kuti, somebody giving jaykara. Joy this, that. After that, Prabhupada asking, who was giving joy? Oh, that man. But it's the jaykara of Mayavadi. Those who are pure devotee, their sensitivity is so high, only by looking at you, only by looking, they can understand you are Mayavadi. Only that much power there. So I told that Mayavadi Acharya, who is in guise of Gaudiya Acharya, foolish number one, is going to, destroy the whole society. Infinity beyond, they cannot get respite. Infinity pure, I challenge, infinity pure. Those who are, Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, those who are going to prove that they are from this parampara, and they are going against, secretly they are going against parampara, Gaudiya Dhara parampara, surely they are Mayavadi. They should be isolated. They should be thrown out of this society. I told him that you are going to prove your chastity, you know. One day, I was there somehow for one night in that temple. Morning time, I am coming out because I have no time. I am not staying anywhere somehow. I was bound to go there because they request me. And while I am coming out, I am discussing those devotees. They are very nice devotees. Somehow they are going to marry to maintain their family because father, mother, they are okay. You can allow them to do seva here. And in a week, one time they can go to Rome. They, in front of public, speaking in front of me, my Gurudev never teach that way. I say, idiot, okay. You are going to prove your chastity, but you are pros, I know. Eh? I tell you, what wrong in this? Gosai Maharaj was allowed. Gosai Maharaj was allowed. Chitta Gosai Maharaj, Bhakti Vilas Chitta Gosai Maharaj was married. Eh? Then? Eh? Why you are going to show this way? Why you are going to show this way? You know? Okay, I don't speak. After that, I told him that your Gurudev never teaches. Your Gurudev, you are speaking, I am not different from your Gurudev. But at the same time, my Gurudev never told you. Aha, big chastity. Now it is proved that he is pros number one. By his activities, all secrets happen. This is the condition. I told him, you see, one example. One day, there was a big fire in a building. There was a small gas oven breakup, and one brahmachari, very smart brahmachari, was there, very stout figure, and Gurudev was there. Everybody come out, one small girl of 14 years, 15 years, she was trapped inside. She can run and come out, but she cannot come out. She is fearing. Then Gurudev speaking to that brahmachari, my son, can you go and rescue my daughter there? Can you go? He is speaking, Gurudev, if you give me order, I can rescue. Then he run and go inside and catch that girl and come out, outside. And she was saved, Gurudev bless. You know, but brahmachari usually not going to touch Matajis. But the situation is so sensitive. Situation is so sensitive. A life and death question. Eh? Foolish? A question of love and many life and, you know, death and love. Then I told example to that brahmachari, that foolish sannyasi, foolish acharya, Gurudev that time was bound to give order to that brahmachari to rescue that small girl because she was trapped inside fire. That doesn't mean if that brahmachari coming out, and in after that brahmachari speaking, Guru Maharaj give me permission to touch all Matajis, you know, girls. Idiot number one. Eh? That was sensitive situation that doesn't mean Gurudev giving permission for that brahmachari to touch any Matajis, any brahmachari. Right? You are speaking like that. I told that in a foolish acharya. That was a special situation for why. And if the brahmachari is really brahmachari, perfect brahmachari, and he is inclined to Gurudev, he cannot take that kind of siddhanta. It's wrong siddhanta. So when I am speaking harikatha, different kind of example, I am going some illustration, example, milestone, that doesn't mean you will have to imitate. You never love Guru Vaishnava, you cannot follow Guru Vaishnava properly from heart, you can show some imitation. You are imitation gold. Imitation gold. This way you like to prove that you are a great Vaishnava. You want to prove. When Mahaprabhu was, when Mahaprabhu was bound to give some Mahaprasadam to Narayani Devi, Narayani was 5 years girl, daughter of the brother of Shivas Pandit. Mahaprabhu was there after taking prasadam, giving some prasadam. Narayani, take this prasadam. Those idiot sahajiyas, they find one loophole. Mahaprabhu also used to, love Narayani. They like to represent one dirty picture. This is our corrupted society. This is a corrupted educational institution, all corrupted. Everything, spiritual organization, everything, all corrupted. Those who are doing research in Calcutta University, those idiot writing, Mahaprabhu was in love with Vishnupriya, Lakshmipriya, love marriage. If I get that scholar, I like to beat with my chappal in his face. And the chancellor, idiot chancellor, they like to approve that doctorate degree. This is the situation of this corrupted society. Where I can speak Harikatha? Who can hear? I am foolish, wasting my time. People like to imitate. They cannot understand, take the essence of the teachings. They cannot understand. So, here the sloka I started with, you see. Devarsi bhutatmaninam pitrinam na kinkara nayam rinicha rajana sarvatmana ya saranam saranyam gato mukundam parihitva kartam. Those who are going to submit 100% unto the lotus feet of Mukundo through Guru Vishnu, but directly submission not possible, which you cannot see, which you cannot feel. How you can show submission? Through Guru Vishnu. That's why it is written, Devarsi bhutatmaninam pitrinam na kinkara nayam rinicha rajana. Usually all human beings, they are going to take birth in this world. They have some, duty. If they don't do, we are all indebted to Rishi Muni. We are indebted to our forefathers. We are indebted to society. We are indebted to all, animals and, creatures here. I can show you. Maybe if today time it permits, I can touch how you can develop Apara. That's why Guru Maharaj was crying and crying. Guru Maharaj wanted to show that, Baba, my son, if you cannot do bhajan, still okay. Someday you can do. But don't try to commit any aparadh. Don't try to commit any aparadh. Be careful. If you do aparadh, you can go down and down and down. You can be heartless, Padavati, the wife of Jayadev. Padavati, the wife of Jayadev Goswami. I can discuss. Is Abhirbhav coming? I can discuss Thirubhava. I can show you. Jayadev Goswami going to identify Padavati Charan Charan Chakravarti. Jayadev Goswami going to identify, I am moving around on the lotus feet of Padavati. And you are going to hate. You think you are a big devotee. Eh? You are going to prove that you are a big devotee because you are maintaining purity. I can show you the result of your purity. I am coming. Eh? I am showing you. Jini Parthipo Kartabbo, this material, who is going to show 100% submission unto lotus feet of Supreme Lord, Guru Vaishnava. Yes, unto lotus feet of pure Guru Vaishnava. Yes, no duty left. No duty left in this material world. No duty left. Devarshi, Bhutatma Ninam, Pitrinam, no King Karana, no duty in this 14 world. He has no duty left because he is 100% surrendered soul unto a lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava, unto a lotus feet of Mukunda. He is going to cut all his previous everything, all on everything, anartha, everything all cut, all duties, everything, because Naraji Maharaj speaking, yatha tarar molli sechanena tippanti tatkund tatkand bhujopasakha. Yatha tarar molli sechanena tippanti tatkund bhujopasakha. Pranopoharasu yathendriyanam tataiva arharanam achyutejya. When I am going to accept the lotus feet of Prabhu, Guru Vaishnava, I mean Nityananda and Gaur Hari, then all finish. My duty, all my duty, all finish. No duty is there. The only duty is to show devotion, is to do bhakti unto lotus feet of the, that is our sole duty, only duty. Only duty we have. But when we are staying in this material world, when you are leading our family life, which is more safe at present, I am very upset. Still today, people from foreign country or those who are here, they want to say that we are foreign devotee. For us, rules and regulations different. Why? Why you are speaking this? Why you are going to proclaim that way? Devotee mean devotee. Devotee mean devotee. Why you are make some gradation? We are foreign devotee, so we can do whatever you like. Eh? You can throw your wife, you can accept your whatever you like, you can do. You are foreign devotee. Eh? You are not at all devotee. Devotee mean devotee. If you are going to accept Vedic culture, if you are going to accept Bhagavad Dharma, you will have to follow in toto. If you have some personal, you know, personal like and dislike, it's not so big factor. I am less interested. It is about that. You have to lead your life properly. What wrong in it? What wrong you see? What wrong you find? You know, you have so many defects inside you. You are going to find fault with, you know, why? Try to lead your life according to scriptural analysis, advice. So if you are at all going to accept this Vedic culture, if you are at all going to accept this Bhagavad Dharma, why you are going to speak this way? What is the problem that you are going to keep your wife throwing your wife out? Why? You can prove there is any mistake done by her. Eh? Fancifully you can lie, I can stay separately. Why you can stay separately? Eh? Actually, at present, Grihastha life is very good. At present, Grihastha life is very good. Kapat sannyasi, kapat brahmachari can go to hell for infinity period. At present, anybody want to speak me, Maharaj, I like to come, renounce. No! I said, no, I cannot allow you. I know you cannot do. I am not a cheater. If somebody says, Maharaj, I like to enter into renounce. No! You go. And stay in home, at home. Try to live normal life, like Mahaprabhu told to Raghunath Das Gosai. Sthir hoiya ghare jao naha vatul. Krome krome pai loke bhava sindhu kul. Gradually people can get, you know, get solution. So you go to home. Markat vairagya na karo lok dekhaiya. Don't try to open a show business, exhibition of vairagya. Don't try to show that. Mahaprabhu speaking. Markat vairagya like monkey. Markat vairagya na karo lok dekhaiya. Yatha yogya vishaya bhunjo anasakto hiya. Without any affinity inside heart, you go on accepting family matters, everything, you because you are in family. Bhaktivinoda Thakur is the idealism. How nicely Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to lead his family life, at the same time going to maintain this devotional world. Whoa, what? How powerful, you know? Even in dream we cannot imagine. Oh, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, ah, Bhagavan. All duty, government duty doing, social duty doing, everything, you know, all is doing in relation to Krishna. So fine technique he is doing. He's going to do, show these kind of devotional activities. External people have no information that is a great devotee. He is a personal associate of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Nobody knows. A foolish, they don't know. At present, those foolish people, they are dying, they are being cheated because they want to be cheated. I have no solution. What to do? I can speak this way. If anybody want to enter, no, enter into the, no, you go and stay. I know you cannot. At all, you are going to open one false exhibition of Vairagya. And you don't know what kind of severe punishment you can get by false exhibition of Vairagya. Better you can stay. Loveful relation with wife, children, everything. And you can say, Maharaj, I am Grihastha, I am a fallen soul, I cannot do. This is called humble mood. Sivas Pandit and all Advaita Gosai, who not? There, or Siram Pandit, or everybody. You know, Sarvamataja Joe, they are all going to show that we are Prabhu, we are actually Grihastha, we are no power. This way. This way, in Kalikal, is very dangerous. Very dangerous. Every fraction of second you can do aparat, commit aparat. You can think he is not at all, she is not at all devotee. I am devotee. Then you are going to fall down. That's why Guru Padma used to write one all the time. Baba, Vaishnava aparat. A fast book, Guru Maharaj was very interested because to protect people fall down. Guru Maharaj was bound to write Vaishnava aparat. It was later translated. And the name of the book was Heart of Krishna. Heart of Krishna. I can show the letter of Prabhupada. Prabhupada writing, Kesava Goswami, Vaman Goswami, they are writing. I am also sometime writing letters to some Matajis. Because they are, you know, crying. They are, you know. So, I am bound to write to them. And Prabhupada used to write letters to them. If you read that, those letters, you can go mad. So nice. You can realize how much love and affection Prabhupada have for them. Externally, Prabhupada is going to show some strict procedure so that common people can get this kind of teachings. Common people, they are watching, they are always waiting to see some loophole of a Vaishnava. Common people, they are so foolish, they are always waiting to find our loopholes of one Vaishnava. And they can do, I am Maharaj down, that's why I am doing. They can speak this way. So we don't like to allow any scope so that people can give some example. Maharaj down, that's why we are maintaining strictness. That doesn't mean we hate, no. So, Naraji Maharaj going to give example. Same example is applicable. Naraji Maharaj giving, hey Rajan, if somebody is going to give water in the root, at the root of that tree, then whole tree, you know, can get nourishment. Yatha tararamon lise chanena tippanti taskanda hujopusaka. All branches and leaves, everything, you know, can get nourishment. Because water we are going to give there at the root. So, the root cause of this infinity world is Krishna Govinda. Ishvara Parama Krishna Sachidananda Vigraha Anadi Radhi Govinda Sarva Karana Karana. That's why if you are going to do bhakti 100%, no kapat, no duplicity, if you are going to show 100% pure devotion unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord, then there is no duty left for us. And otherwise, any people taking birth in this world, they are always indebted to Rishi Munis. How to pay Rishi Munis? We will have to practice their advice, scriptural analysis given by them. We will have to, there is a Rishi Din, we will have to practice Rishi Munis, they are giving advice, their Shastras, we can follow. And Pitri, fathers, if you are at all not going to enter into renounce order, that is totally separate thing. Then, if you enter into Grihastha life, you will have to give birth to a children, I mean boy, son. Then you can, not the question of enjoyment. You can get free. Then after that, Bhutarin, you have some duty for other people here in the societies, you have to do. In relation to Krishna, like that Maharaj, you know, Ranti Dev, I told you. So this way, all small creatures also, you have all duty, you know, Bhutarin, Pitrin, Devarin, all demigods, you will have to offer something to them. so that you can get rid of the debt you already have for there heavenly planets they are staying demigods you also in Gita also Mahaprabhu says this way yogya was arranged vishva yoggo order a big order of yoga was established by Brahma so that each and everybody by mutual cooperation can get satisfaction you will have to serve demigods you will have to offer so that they can also eat something get some water and clarified butter everything I am not going to advise you to worship separate demigods no but it is for all general people in the world those who are going to show krishna bhakti for they the only duty that I already told yatha tarar mon lisechanena tippanti taskand hujau pusaka pranopaharasya yatendriyanam tathaiva sarva arhanam achyuteya when we are going to keep prasadam inside our mouth then automatically we are chewing and going inside our belly stomach and then we are again getting a full nourishment this way krishna bhakti can give full nourishment to you but for other people there are four different kind of devarim pituriyam bhutoriyam everything you have to fulfill without completing your duty paying your duty discharging your duty without discharging your duty cannot get rid but if at all you are going to show krishna bhakti then you can lead your family life very nicely especially those who are favorable those favorable so nice family they can maintain nice bhakti where from you are going to develop this kind of pashanda buddhi this kind of heartless conception coming inside your heart where from you are teaching this so those who are going to show their 100% submission unto lotus feet of krishna mukunda they have no duty left in their life devarsi bhutatmaninam pitrinam na kinkara nayam rinicharayana sarvatmana ya saranam sarannam gato mukundam parihitu kartam it is the duty of acharya to teach those disciples that way Popa speaking those who are actual acharya they can also help you to manifest the meaning of mantra not that today I will have to give initiation to hundreds of people initiation though what kind of initiation by preserving all anartha previously already stored by their wrong activities aparad pap a sadguru never can initiate sadguru first can wait and see the situation of jivatma and those jivatma can also watch by the because it is the teachings written by sanatan goswami hari bhakti vilas they can also develop their mood and a darshan power to see gurudev to realize what is the mood of gurupad padma what is the baba and gurupad padma also can watch them what is their mood not that or useless fully useless for krishna bhajan oh you come I can give dikha both of them going to hell I already told yesterday that if you are going to get mantra from a wrong source it is the advice of shastra there is no aparad avaishnava mukhopadishtam mantrena nirayam bhajet if you are not going to take mantra from a pure vaishnav then if there is contamination so many jealousy everything so many things are there you have to throw that guru you cannot accept so you will how you can understand so sahajya whole society is sahajya they don't like to accept the siddhanta vichara popadan bhakti vinod so I can conclude in infinity period they cannot get krishna because they are not ready to accept that siddhanta vichara popadan bhakti vinod that's why I am speaking that way avaishnava mukhopadishtam mantrena nirayam bhajet if you are going to take mantra from a bonded soul fallen soul who is acting as guru then you will have to go to hell and that who is going to give mantra to you, he is also going to. So it is written in the advice of Shastra, punascha vidhina, It is the order of Shastra that you will have to accept, and again you will have to accept Sadguru. You will have to accept Sadguru. You have to go for initiation again. You know, Avaishnava Mukhavadishtam Mantrena Nirayam Bhajat Punasta Vidina Grahet Vaishnava Bhadguru. Who is pure Vaishnava, he will have to accept from mantra from him. There is the rules and regulation. You can remember, yesterday I was speaking one sloka in the beginning. Marto yatha, marto yada, takto samasta karma, niveditatma, vichikirsito me, tadamritattam pratibaddhamana, mayatma bhuyayo kalpate boi. Maransil manus, those who are mortal, man is mortal. If those jiva, those jivatma, those jiva, mana, they are going to throw all their duty, especially human beings, they are going to throw their duties, everything, you know, and going to submit unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. They are going to totally harmonize their desire with Supreme Lord and Guru Vaishnava and Supreme Lord. Totally harmonize. Then surely they are going to get nectar. Nectar means devotion. Without devotional achievement, nobody can show this kind of thing. Nobody can show that kind of patience in front of death. Death is inevitable. In front of death, pure Guru Vaishnava not going to change their decision. Better they can die, but still they cannot change their decision. So in that case, they can get Amrita. You know, they can get Amrita, I mean bhakti, and Bhagavan can stay inside their heart, take rest. So Chidananda Bhagavan, Satchidanandamaya Bhagavan, and Supreme Lord is there going to sit inside their heart. So all problems funny, finished. All problem finished. Problem is one thing, Prabhupada, I can discuss next day. You need not remind me, I can remember. Prabhupada speaking, there is countless problem, pivoted on a single problem that we don't like to understand Advaita Gyan Tattva. Prabhupada speaking, I can discuss next day. So when Martha, mortal, I mean human being, those are death is inevitable, whereas they know it for sure, death is inevitable. We are going to live for some years, some months, some fortnight, from some week, for some, you know, days, for some hours, for some minute, for some second, a mathematical calculation of our, mathematical interpretation of our life. Samarto yada takto samasta karma, all going to throw duty. That I told you na yesterday. Even basic things you can find in Gita. In front of Arjun, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, sarva dharmana prityajya mamekam saranam bhaja, aham tvam sarva papebhyo mokshayishyami ma sucho. The basic thing, you have to understand this thing. Ignoring Gita, you can never come out successful. First of all, you have to understand the science of Gita. What Krishna wanted to say? You have to change your ugly lifestyle. You have to be more scientific in devotional life. You are going to follow a fanciful attitude. How you can come out successful? You are giving pain to all other jivatmas. You think you are elevated? Because you memorize something? Marto yada takto samasta karma nivedita atma bijigir sito me. When they are hunting me, searching me fervently from heart, where is Krishna? Our life should be dedicated for this seva. We are in search of Krishna all the time. And by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, we can get the information and we can start seva. So, bijigir sito me. Tada amridattam padivaddhamana, even I told from 7th canto, the Siddhanta Prahladma. When Martha, material man, you know, here, going to leave all enjoying mood, going to throw out all enjoying mood. In that case, you know, they can Bhagavataya Kalpate. I told many times before, is a Siddhanta Prahlad Maharaj. You know, Jayan Jivatma going to throw all enjoying nothing. By the support of Yukta Vairagya, when Jivatma going to serve Supreme Lord the best possible way, then immediately he can get the divine power of Supreme Lord. Bhagavataya Kalpate. Marto Yada Takta Samasta Karma here. And there Prahlad Maharaj thinking, when, you know, Manabo Manusustitan, when Kamano Manusustitan, any kind of desire, kama, there inside, any smell, when any human being going to throw out, in that case he is going Bhagavataya Kalpate. That time he is going to get the power of Supreme Lord. Not before that. Kapat Bairagya, Kapat Sanyas, nothing can get no result. Can yield no result. Nothing. Useless. It is better to follow Grihastha life. You know? Very, you know, scientific way. So, in that case, Bhagavan speaking in front of Uddhava, Uddhava, tada amritattam patipaddamano. He can get that nectar. Nectar means bhakti. Mai bhakti rhi bhutanam amritottaya kalpati. He can get nectar and he can enjoy, because if bhakti is not there, different kind of dissatisfaction can come. If bhakti is there, no problem. Only one problem. There is no bhakti. Our Krishnadas Babaji Maharaj used to speak, where from you are getting so much problem? Eh? There is only one problem, that we cannot speak Hare Krishna. Where from you are getting so much argument and so much thing? Baba, my son, there is only one word, Hare Krishna. That is the only solution. But we are going to, you know, jump into the fire of Maya. Okay, as you like. As you like, if you like to jump into fire of Maya, you can do it. How, who am I to check you? I have, eh? You cannot discover any relationship. Eh? You cannot discover any relationship between Supreme Lord and me, you. You know, this way, you can lead your life fancifully. What to do? Mayatma Bhuyaya Kalpate mean that Jivatma can get Chidananda, transcendental bliss. Can get transcendental bliss. You know? Also, I can discuss, I already discussed maybe long ago, Bhavapu Varga Bhamato Yada Bhavet Janasatarihi Yachita Sasamagamaha Satsang. I can discuss this point next day. Next day. You know, now you see, Acharya, it is the duty of Acharya to install bhakti inside the heart of those who are coming to them. First of all, they will have to clean the heart of those who are coming to take diksha. If Gurudev is going to preserve all his previous anartha, all everything dirty, and going to give diksha, and disciple those who are coming to take diksha as those who don't understand what is submission, nothing, they are not going to submit, you know, unto lotus feet of Guru Padma. I told yesterday, without submitting everything, top to bottom, even your body, speech, mind, everything, without submitting everything, one cannot get Dibya Gyan through Diksha. At all, if someone going to take Diksha from some Sadguru, he cannot get complete Diksha. He cannot get Dibya Gyan. This kind of submission should be there. If there is kapat bab, then it's not, you cannot come out successful. Also, I was speaking yesterday, that six different kind of saranagati folds are there. I already yesterday was bound to seek Dainya Atma Nivedan, Guptitya Varan, Avasharukhya. I told you yesterday, Kirtan, written by Bhaktivinoda Thakur. And after that, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is going to show humble attitude. Rupa Sanatana Pade Dantatina Gori Bhakti Vinoda Pare Duhupada Dori. Bhaktivinoda Thakur going to catch the lotus feet of Rupa Sanatana and crying, and prostrated Dandavada and praying and crying. You know, Rupa Sanatana Pade Dantatina Gori and Bhakti Vinoda Pare Duhupada Dori. Kandiya Kandiya Vale Amito Hadam. By crying and crying and crying and crying and speaking, Prabhu, I am fallen, I am fallen. No way out. No way out. If you can excuse me, then I can go. If you can help me. Shikhai Saranagati Bhaktero Pran. Every time we are giving lecture. Ah, Mara, Saranagati is the basic thing, you know. But you foolish, you understand what is Saranagati? If you are at all going to show Saranagati, how you are doing this kind of mistake? You are going to disturb the whole my seva system here. You are going to make disturbance, you are going to break. No making, only breaking. You know only breaking. You are Kali. Only you know how to break. I am making, you are breaking. Prabhupada saying, only breaking, no making. They can do this thing. That they know very good. You know, yesterday I was speaking from Haribhakti Vilas. Anukulyasya sankalpaha pratikulya vivarjanam rakshishyatiti vishvasagaptitya varunam tatha atmo nikhyepa karpanyam saravi saravida saranagatihi. Six kyle of saranagati. I am going to discuss this point. Surely I can discuss that how Prabhupada wanted to speak. We cannot rectify a pure acharya. Pure acharya is self-manifested. One cannot construct acharya, reconstruct the character of acharya. One cannot give training to acharya. Is self-manifested. Then I can show, I can prove that acharya is, you know, there cannot be any fault. It's flawless, stainless. You know, stainless. Acharya, there cannot be any spot in character, nothing. Self-manifested. So much deep philosophy. So much deep philosophy here in Gaudiya, you know, society, Saraswat Gauri society, even in infinity pure, we cannot digest. So many things are there. We are busy with fighting. We are busy with, you know, dirty purity. Dirty purity. Aha. What kind of purity you have? A Krishna sitting inside your heart. That's why you are kicking me. Eh? Krishna sitting inside your heart. That's why you like to kick me. You know, foolish number one. Sa anukullasya sankalpaha pratikulya vivarjanam rakshasya shiti vishyasa guptitya varunam tatha atmo nikhepa karpanyam sharavida saranagati. Six different kind of, you know, saranagati, folds of saranagati. What is favorable for Krishna bhakti? That we can do. Rupa Goswami was speaking same thing, you know. Anukulya, you know, anukulya, you know, anukula radharani, under her guidance we can do it. You know, Rupa Goswami already told in sloka, in, you know, Rasamrita Sindhu, you know. So, anna vilasita sunyam jnana karmadi anabritam anukulena krishnanu silanam bhaktir uttama. If you cannot enter into Uttama Bhakti, so a big discussion, a detailed discussion of Raya Ramana Sangha is very urgent. Very urgent. The foolish people I wanted to discuss, you know, I myself don't understand. By the mercy of Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda, if I can understand something, if I can reciprocate my feeling, you know, that's why I'm trying it, that is. So Gita is very urgent, but no time, only 3rd chapter, 45 sloka up to, we can try. Maybe lift telegas we can go from, do from Goshala is more practical. All the time we cannot go. So, anukulyasa sankalpa mean, what is favorable to Krishna bhakti. Favorable mean what Krishna, going to approve. What you like to approve, that is not. That is, I am not speaking. What Krishna like to approve. Krishna bhakti ja unigo, what is favorable for Krishna bhakti that you must do, what is against Krishna bhakti pratikul, You must have strong resolution to throw out Krishna Bhakti Ja Pratikul, which is against Krishna Bhakti. You will have to throw out everything. Krishna can protect me, no problem. That kind of strong belief should be there inside your heart. He can protect me. Krishna is the only, you know, controlling me, you know, maintaining me. My maintenance, everything is being done by Krishna, by Gauranga. I am not maintaining Goshala, I am not maintaining Banijava, nothing. Who am I? Who am I? I cannot. If I at all have submission, then it is automatically done. Automatically done. How I am? You know, how to maintain Goshala, how to expand so many. Everything Krishna is maintaining, you see. Why should I fear? Krishna going to maintain me, Palan Karta. He should know it for sure. My desire, there should not, I should not develop separate desire. His desire, I should harmonize my desire with Krishna. The day I am successful to harmonize my desire with Guru Vaishnava and Bhagavan, then I am successful. It is called Atmanika. Karpanya means humbleness. I am so fallen, I am so fallen, I am so fallen. Guru Vaishnava is speaking so heavily. That doesn't mean they are going to lose their humbleness. That doesn't mean they are going to lose humbleness. Because they are speaking heavily to rectify all those bonded souls. There is one kind of treatment. And not that they have karma inside, that's why they are angry. No! You know, no, not that. You know, they always think that I am a fallen soul. If they are not going to feel that way, they can never speak Harikatha. If they have any desire to arrange, collect personal patishtha, they can never speak Harikatha. So Prabhupada giving number one argument. Prabhupada speaking, those who are not having any smell of desire, any smell of desire to collect patishtha, actually Trinadapi. But we think, Kesava Goswami is speaking heavily, that's why he is not Trinadapi. Santo Goswami are there heavily, that's why they are not Trinadapi. We think this way. We think this way, so foolish. But Trinadapi is only possible for a devotee to show who is having no desire, personal patishtha, no smell. So, a pure Vaishnava always maintaining this kind of Trinadapi bhava, humble attitude. They are always thinking, I am fallen soul, I have nothing, I am nothing, I am fallen soul. That's why they can speak Harikatha. Because the condition, third condition given by Mahaprabhu, Trinadapi sunijana tararapi sahishuna, amanino manandino kirtaniya sadahari. Harikirtan can only be done, Harikirtan can only be done if I can satisfy this condition. If I am not Trinadapi, if I am not going to show honor to, you know, you all, if I have some enjoying mood, then I can never speak Harikatha. It is the condition. It is a scientific condition, you know, set by Mahaprabhu. I have to maintain that kind of patience. People going to insult me, people going to, you know, throw me out, going to against me. Still, I have to maintain patience. Because if I cannot maintain patience, then in infinity pure Harinam cannot come. Harinat cannot dance. Harinam cannot dance in my mouth, even tongue. Mahaprabhu speaking, Trinadapi sunijana tararapi sahishuna, amanena manadena kirtaniya sadahari. If you like to get the quality, get the capacity, I mean the quality, kripa, to sing the glories of Supreme Lord and Guru Vaishnava, you must follow this procedure. You must become Trinadapi, otherwise not. So those who are Banishava, I cannot expect that kind of, you know, that kind of false ego. Those who are doing actual, Vani Seva, how I can expect they can show that kind of a false ego? How they can feel that we are more than that, you know, more than you are? I am a great devotee. Huh? If Guru Vaishnava throw you out from mind, you can go anywhere in the world. Anywhere you can go. I challenge, you can go. If you are going to lose the kripa of Guru Vaishnava, you can become a beggar. You can become more than a beggar in the spiritual field. Nobody going to ask you any question. So poor condition you can meet. Don't try to do aparad, Vaishnava aparad. Different kind of aparad moods I can discuss surely, but time cannot permit today, I think. So you see, this way, I already discussed that the Acharya must prove this. All Acharyas, they should have idealism, and we should watch Acharya, what Acharya doing. Acharya will have to, because the acharana of Acharyas mean important, so we are going to learn. If Acharya not going to teach me properly, if there is no idealism, what I can learn? I can become a monkey. Monkey, na? We are making monkey and garbage in the name of Diksha. Are, if you like to give Diksha, why not you give proper Diksha? You can give Diksha, but you will have to give proper Diksha. You understand what is the meaning of that mantra? You yourself don't understand, you have no realization, you are going to give Diksha. And you know, unauthentic children, you are giving birth, unauthentic children, you know. Monkey, you are making some monkey in societies, you know, garbage. So if you at all like to give, you try to take Diksha first. Try to understand what is Diksha, try to explain what is Diksha, try to realize what is Diksha. Who is Guru Tattva? You try to explain. Why you are everybody, Maharaj, give me Diksha. Foolish people. Giving Diksha. Great. More merciful than Rup Sanatan, Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur. They want to prove this way. They want to prove. We are more elevated than, they are nothing, Bhaktivinoda Thakur Prabhupada. They are speaking all lie, you know. So idealism, Acharya is the main thing. If they cannot maintain idealism, how they can teach the whole society? Make some garbage? Only they can make some garbage. So first thing we need is to rectify the whole situation. Who can? Prabhupada speaking, when the situation is total out of order, then Bhagavan Supreme Lord going to, jada jada hi dharmasya glanir bhavati bharata av bhutvanam adharmasya tadatmanam siyanyaham, this sloka. Prabhupada speaking, sometime Supreme Lord himself coming, sometime deputing, going to depute, meaning going to send some of his personal messengers who can rectify the situation, try to rectify. You know, this way. Yesterday, you can remember, I was discussing about different acharyas in different fields of devotional mark, you know, 9 folds of devotion, I told you. Different acharyas are there. So, there all, you know, from Paddavali, I told this, you know, sloka also. And Prahlad Maharaj already told, Savanam, Kirtanam, Vishnusmar, everything I told, many times before. Yesterday I told, Se Vishnu, Sravane, Parikshid, Abhavat, Vayasaki Kirtane. The idealism of a singer of the glories of Supreme Lord is Sukadev Goswami. And it is the idealism of a disciple who can hear Harikatha perfectly, the idealisms said by Parikshit Maharaj. Sri Vishnu Sravane Parikshit Abhavad Vayasaki Kirtane Prahad Smarane. Swaran, continuous, non-stop remembrance. Swaran, Prahlad. And Angri Seva, Charan Seva, Lakshmi Devi, Prithu Maharaj in Pujan, you know. Akrur Maharaj in Abhivandan, Kapipati Hanumanji Maharaj in Dasa, Shaksho, Friendship, Arjuna, and Sarvatma Nivedane Balir Abhut Krishnapti Resha Param. There is the absolute way to attain Krishna Bhakti in different fields. And in Chaitanya Chaitamati routine, Ekango Shade Kimba Shade Bahuango. Maybe sometime one mode of devotion you are following. Sometime two modes, sometime five modes, sometime nine folds, like Ambarish Maharaj, you know. Ambarish Maharaj going to apply all the nine folds of bhakti. Shabai mana Krishna padaravinda yor bachaansi vaikunta gunan varnane karohan karoharer mandira marjana adishu shutim chakarachita sadakato dai mukunda lingalaya darshane drisho tad vitta gatto sparshi anga sangamam ghrananca tat pad saroj saurave simattulasya rasanam tadarpite Padu hare ketro padanu sarpani, siro risi keso padavi pandani, kamancha dasse notu kam kamaya, yatottamasloko janasrayarati. So you see, you can recite with me. Savai mana Krishna padarabinda yorubachansi vaikunta bunanu varnani. Karo hare ramandira marjana adishu shruti shruti shrutin chakarachita sadakatho daye mukunda lingalayo darshane drisho tad vitta gatto sparshe anga sangamam ghrananco tat pad saroja saurabe simattulasya rasanam tadarpite padau hare khetro padanu sarpani Siro Rishikesha Padavi Bandhani Kamancha Dasse Natu Kama Kamaya Jathottama Sroka Janasraya Arati Srila Ambarish Maharaj, I can discuss this slok someday. Srila Ambarish Maharaj going to practice all the nine folds of bhaktis, but under the guidance of Yukta Vairagya. Under the guidance of Yukta Vairagya, doing everything, but under the guidance of Yukta Vairagya. If there is no Yukta, you know, how Janak Maharaj is great. How Janak Maharaj is so great, so great, so great, Tattabhid. All Munirishis, you know, everybody going to pray prostrate at Dandavar unto his lotus feet to know Tattva Gyan. How possible? Janak Maharaj is a great Janak Maharaj Rajarsi. Janak Maharaj Rajarsi. He is king, big king. At the same, he is so great Rishi, so great Tattva Jnani. Everybody going. Even Sukhdev Goswami also, you know, Vyasadeva Goswami was bound to send Sukhdev Goswami in front of, you know, that king, you know, for testing, a great king and great devotee, you know, going to send him. Because if we cannot get approval from Guru Vaishnava, if we are not going to get approval from pure Guru Vaishnava, pure Guru Vaishnava means, those who are going to follow Sarup Gosai, Sarup Gosai. Those who are going to follow Sarup Gosai in toto, I can speak, they are pure Guru Vaishnava. In our, you know, Gaudiya field. Those who are going to ignore Sarup Gosai, they are not pure Guru. It's quite impossible to follow Sarup Gosai. But it is possible, 100%. Those who are actual Gaudiya devotee, they can follow. So, Janak Maharaj is a great devotee. Nobody knows. Janak Maharaj is a so great example in the devotional field. Oh, everybody going, Tattva Gyan. Janak Maharaj going to give. But externally, he is king. Now here you see, Ambarish Maharaj going to apply, practice all nine different kind of folds of bhakti. And in Chaitanya Charitamrita, it is not compulsory, it is not written, Mahaprabhu speaking, ekango sade kimba sade bahu ango. Ekango one fold of bhakti or many fold, maybe two folds of bhakti or three folds of bhakti you can do or all the nine at a time. That's up to you. Ekango sade kimba sade bahu ango. Nishtha hoite upajay premet tarango. Mahaprabhu speaking, well, they can follow one devotional field, one devotional mood, like, you know, Parikshit Maharaj only hearing, successful. Sukadev Goswami singing Harikatha. Parikshit, Prahlad Maharaj in Swaran remembrance, Angri Bhajan, you know, worshipping lotus feet, Lakshini, Prithu Pujan, worship, Akro Abhivandan, glorifying, Dasha, you know, servitors of Hanumanji Maharaj, friendship, Arjuna, Sarvatma Nivedan, submission, all everything. There is a milestone example to us shown by Bali Maharaj. This way, Mahaprabhu saying, it depends upon your tremendous attraction. Ekanga, if you can follow one devotional, you know, mode, that's up to you. But if you can follow two or three devotional modes, that's up to you. Ekanga sadhikin saibum. Nishtha, if there is no accurate, you know, tenacity, nishtha, strong faith, nishtha, strong faith, nishtha idu upaja premettaranga. If you have strong faith, strong nishtha, it can give you the treasure prema. Mahaprabhu speaking. Nishtha idu upaja premettaranga. Prem, you can get prema, everything. But there should be nishtha. If there is no nishtha, how we can? Again, I can come back to the point what Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to speak. This way, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, those who are going to disobey, those who are going to disobey the system set by our Guru Bharga, you know, they are the great enemy of the Sampradaya. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, those who are going to accept this Sampradaya externally, but internally they are going to externally they are going to accept that Sampradaya, but they are totally against Sampradaya. They are doing all their activities can prove that they are against previous Guru Varga. Amnai Dhara, Srauta Pantha, they are going to break. Those who are going to accept externally, and they are going to disobey the system. They are actually the main enemies of this Sampradaya. To give full protection to Sampradaya, Bhagavad Dharma Raksha, Shuddha Bani Amnai Raksha, through Sampradaya Raksha. If you are totally failure, useless, if you are totally failure to give protection to Sampradaya, a Bhagavad Dharma, that's mean total Amna Vishuddha Bani Parampara Bani Vaibhav, you are not going to give protection. Because through Sampradaya Protector, Sampradaya protection, if Sampradaya is going to be protected, Bhagavad Dharma, all principles, rules and regulations going to be protected, then Shuddha Bani, pure Amnai Bani, Sauta Panta can enjoy protection. Without that, so Bhagavad Dharma Sangrakshak, Sampradaya Sangrakshak, Acharya. You know, Sampradayak Vaibhav Sangra Khaiko Acharya. Sometimes we are speaking in his pranam mantra, Prabhupada, you know, big Acharyas, Sarugu Sayade, Paradevi Dawson, Vishwan, we are speaking this way. Only by fighting mood, I am knowing some Shastra, so I can go on fighting with people. What you know? I know everything. I know everything. What you know? You know anything? This way, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Acharya Sabdir Arthaki, what is the actual meaning of Acharya? Acharya means, what is the Bhaktivinoda Thakur means, what is the meaning of actual, what is the actual meaning of Acharya? If we cannot find in all in application, all in applied form, in the life of an Acharya, we can find all Bhagavad Dharma in applied form. That's why you speak Mahabhagavat. Why you are speaking Mahabhagavat? Because we can find everything what he is speaking, Bhagavad Dharma, all we can find in applied form in his own life. That's why we say Bhagavad Dharma we can find in applied form. That's why he's Acharya. No etiquette, no acharya, nothing, only in a pop time. Oh, give me mala, wash my lotus feet. Ah, Kali, 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 you know. Bhaktivinoda is speaking, only to fight with people, to make some, you know, to create some argument, is not the duty of acharya. I can fight. Like Mahaprabhu, you know, wanted to draw one conclusion with that, you know, that, you know, Digvijay Pandit. Digvijay Pandit in Chaitanya Bhagavad Gita, you can find Chaitanya Jitana. Digvijay Pandit is going to collect certificate from Allah. Mahaprabhu speaking, ultimately, what is the conclusion? Your Panditta, your proficiency, everything, it should be only for Krishna Bhakti. Not to show that you are great Pandit, you can collect certificate, you know. Bhaktivinoda was speaking, only I can, you know, create some, I can, you know, make some problem, argument. So through argument, I like to prove that I am big Acharya. Bhaktivinoda was speaking, through arguments, you can get some establishment in this material world. But Acharyaship, it is not Acharyaship. In Gauriya Sampradaya, those who have already received acharyaship, it is, you know, it is their duty to eliminate all anartha, it is their duty. If they cannot eliminate anartha from the heart of disciple, what kind of diksha they can give? Only they can make some garbage that they can. What kind of diksha they can give? If there is no consciousness developed, Maharaj, I am initiated only, you know, 30 years over. Really, really so. If 30 years over, then why you cannot prove that Dibbogyan is there? 30 years over that you have received initiation, but this still there is no, your activities, your lecture, your activities can prove that you are fallen soul. All your lectures and your etiquette, everything, acharya, and what you are doing, totally against scriptural analysis. It can prove that you are bonded soul, not acharya. If you are not going to stop your acharyaship, then is a great danger waiting for you. You know. So, acharya can see Krishna, acharya can see Maya, acharya can see the relationship between Maya and Krishna. Acharya can see the relation between all jivatmas and Krishna. In the tattva gyan, sambandha gyan should be there in full fledged form. Jai Krishna tattva betta sei guru hai. Not that you have some shastra gyan, you can fight with people. Oh, it's great proficiency, you know. An erudite scholar. Idiot. Erudite scholar. What we can do? What it concerned was? You know? Devotion means, if you have devotion, then you can give to. If you have no devotion, how you can give to others? And if you have no devotion, then what you can give? That's why it is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita. You know, it is written, that for preaching you need only bhakti. Only you need bhakti. If there is no bhakti, what you can give? Jai Krishna tattva betta sei guru hai. Sei guru hai. If there is no tattva betta, no Krishna, you know, nothing there, what you can give to him? What you can give? If devotion is there, you can distribute devotion. I already discussed so many points. The advice by Jatha Haru Ninam Bhaktir Vavishvati. I already told you many times before. It's the instruction of our previous, Brahmaji Guru. Brahmaji speaking to Naraji. And Acharya can give me sambandha gyan. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing in Kirtan, if I can get actual sambandha gyan from Sadguru, And if there is no duplicity inside my heart, then diksha kale shishya kare atmasampan sei kale krishna tare kare atmasam sei deho kare dar chidanandamay aprakita dehe krishne kare. There is a system. Follow what I say. So sambandha gyan if not there, what Gurudev can give? Even Prabhupada speaking, if initiation given Sadguru, he can also manifest the meaning of mantra. If you are chanting mantra for the past 20 years, but still today you don't understand the meaning of mantra, then your mantra japa is not successful. Follow what I say. Follow. You cannot come out successful. If you are doing mantra japa, okay, you can go on doing, but ultimately if you are not going to feel the meaning of mantra, then what kind of mantra you are doing? If you cannot see in Shastra, it is written mantra and mantra devata. The mantra I am chanting, given by Guru Padma, and the mantra, you know, relating to that, you know, God, I mean, Guru Vaishnava or Supreme Lord, mantra devata, na? The mantra. The devota are concerned with this mantra. If I cannot understand this mystery, then how I can do? You know, I can get tattvajna. So, mantra devota and mantra, you should understand. Who is mantra devota? Who is mantra? And Vyasadeva Goswami also, Vyasadeva Goswami, by the mercy of Naraji Maharaj, was able. He was Saktavya's avatar, but still I must speak according to the instruction given there in Bhagavatam. Sukadev, actually, Vyasadeva Goswami, by the mercy of Naraji Maharaj, was successful to see. Bhakti yogena manasi sammak pranihita amale apashyat purusham purunam mayancha tadapasraya jayasan mahita jiva atmanam tigunatmakam paro opi manute anartham tatkitan chavi paddhati anartha upasamam sakshat bhakti yoga madhakshaji. I can discuss all in details next day. So Vyasadeva Goswami could see the Supreme Lord clearly by the mercy. I can see, you know, bhakti yogena manasi sammak pranita amala apashat purusham purna mayanchatava purna purush. I am in Supreme Lord, backside Maya, bowing down backside Supreme Lord, Maya, you know, and everything. And by the magic spell of that Maya, all, you know, infinite universe, they are feeling some magic spell. And Sarup Shakti also, Vyasadeva Goswami is Krishna, and with him Shakti, Sarup Shakti, outside, Maya Shakti, all everything, you know, this way. Now, if we cannot understand the meaning of anartha, those who are acting as acharya, suppose if I am going to speak some, give some lecture to you, if I cannot understand anartha, how I can help you to cut anartha? How I can help you to cut anartha if I myself cannot understand? So, about anartha I can discuss. In this anartha is great danger. If anartha, smell of anartha is there, we can never come out successful. Bhaktivinoda Thakur discussing, Vishwanatha Chakravarti also in discussing. So, there is four different kind of defects there. Anartha, asattishna, you know, tremendous material desire, asattishna, hidaya dobolo, weakness of heart, like poison. Aparat, there is aparat, different kind of affairs are there. Analytically, we can discuss, because Acharya Tattva is very typical Tattva. If we cannot discuss in details, then common people cannot, they cannot remember. They hear Harikatha and forget. What I speak that day, oh Maharaj, I cannot remember. And what kind of hearing, you know? Aparat and Sarup Vibhram. What is Sarup Vibhram? What is aparat? What is asattishna? What is heart, weakness of heart? All I can discuss next day. But be sure, without anartha, without, you know, without eliminating anartha, without eliminating anartha from your heart, if you are going to receive diksha from your Gurudev, that diksha is false diksha. Be sure. Never mind. Because you cannot develop sambandha again. Sambandha janiya bhajite bhajite abhivano habedur. Bhakti Thakur started, cowed, singing. Sambandha janiya bhajite bhajite abhivano habedur. When I can eliminate all my abhiman, false ego, anartha, everything. Sambandha janiya. Gurudev giving sambandha again. Acharya is he who is establishing sambandha again. Not only that, Prabhupada told the unique example of a unique acharya is his unique sevamut. In the life of acharya, you cannot find anything material. All the 24 hours he is busy with seva, 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 nothing else. Then to understand acharya, who is acharya, that you must understand your position also. And who is acharya, you should understand. So sambandha janya, without developing sambandha gyan, you can never do bhajan, you can never eliminate. Adho guru padasraya tasmat krishna dikshadi shikshanam, I already told. So next day, if time permit, I can discuss surely. I can go on discussing, I cannot cut, because if I cut short my discussion, then there can be contradiction, people cannot. That day some Mataji is putting question, and Maharaj, Aparad, how to eliminate? Are, this is, I am going to discuss about Acharya's even Prabhupada, and the unique Acharya's Prabhupada, then I am no skill. But still, now I am entering gradually. Because if you cannot understand the character of devotees, devotional practice of pure devotees, you cannot understand their siddhanta, which are everything. So you can mix and understand. Day by day you can, you are hearing Harikatha. You are hearing Harikatha. But you cannot understand the real meaning. You are going to, just like, Indra Maharaj and, the father of Bali Maharaj, Birochan. Same time, same teaching. But due to sanskar, different sanskar, due to lackage of, understanding, they cannot understand. He can understand different, we can understand it. Big problem can cure. You will have to hear Harikatha continuously. Even one Harikatha, you will have to hear 5-10 times. One Harikatha. 10 times, 5 times, repeatedly. One devotee there, there, outside. He is hearing one Harikatha 5-7 times. After hearing, what is understanding is speaking to me. Maharaj, after hearing 5 times, then I understand this way. So Prabhupada came in the form of Bani Sharup. I am so idiot, I wanted to ignore him. What to speak about you and me? Even some of his disciples wanted to ignore Prabhupada. Bani Sharup. Without understanding the Bani Sharup of Guru Bharga, all my bhajan is useless. You have to understand the Bani Sharup. External stick net, purity, everything they are doing. They are maintaining, because they are going to set some example. That doesn't mean you have to, follow them falsely. Imitate them. You can burn yourself. So Bani Sharup, you have to understand the Bani Sharup of Guru Varga, Acharya. If we cannot understand the Bani Sharup of Acharya, then be sure your diksha is not complete. Or at all, Gurudev, bonded soul, fallen soul, acting as a child. There can be some. So anyway, I am going to stop today because time cannot permit. I have to run right now to Mayapur for some other seva. So, Kipaya Hari Kirtana Murti Dharam Dharani Varaharaka Gaura Janam Janakadika Vasala Snigdha Padam Panamami Sadap Bhupadu Padam Panamami Sadap Bhupadu Padam Panamami Sadap Prabhupadu Padam. वांछा कल्पतरुष्य के बासिंद व्यवचा पतितानं पावन वैष्णवभ्यो नमो नमः।